You get up at dawn, do some exercises, have a cold shower.
Cold shower? Oh, I've got a sore throat. I can hardly speak.
Well,
this is nothing else but the result of your smoking. You definitely smoke too much, Phil. You should give it up. You must do it. For your own good, you know.
Can I start tomorrow?
Can't start what?
My new exciting life, with no cigarettes, with no junk food, but with a lot of exercise and vegetables, with jogging in the morning and aspirin at night.
Do you remember what you told me yesterday, Phil? I think you shouldn't put off till tomorrow what you can do today.
Can I start that after breakfast?
Yes, of course. Why not?
Good. So, this is my breakfast. I'd like one ham and pineapple pizza, two cheeseburgers with French fries, all that followed by a milkshake and a nice cup of coffee with a pack of cigarettes. As soon as I finish all that, I'll be ready for a new healthy life!
Medical complaints.
To be missed. Grammar guys!
You can use should for giving advice or giving opinions. You should do something means it's a good thing to do or a right thing to do.
You should take some aspirin. I think you should stop eating hamburgers and pizzas and go for fresh vegetables instead.
Negative form for should is shouldn't. You shouldn't do something means it's not a good thing to do.
You shouldn't put off till tomorrow what you can do today.
You can use ought to instead of should. It has the same meaning.
You ought to be more energetic, my dear.
For giving strong advice, you use must. Should is not as strong as must.
You should stop smoking. You must stop smoking.
Should and must are modal verbs. Remember that modal verbs have the same form for all persons.
You should start tomorrow. He should start tomorrow.
Don't take auxiliary verb in questions and negatives.
You shouldn't be late. Should we invite her to the party?
And take an infinitive without to.
You should see the doctor. You must be careful.
How would you like your coffee, Phil?
Oh, no milk, no sugar, black. Yeah, I'd like it black.
Black. That's man's coffee. Cool stuff. And here is your pack of cigarettes. Enjoy your breakfast. Have you had aspirin yet?
Oh, yes.
So, how are you now? Better?
No, it's getting even worse.
Now there's only one remedy that can help him. This is his last chance. You know, Phil, I've got a message for you.
Get some cakes again? Max, I can hardly move a finger. I've been totally ruined. And don't forget, I'm leaving tomorrow afternoon. I'm taking a plane to Holland. Look at me, I'm a wreck. How shall I get to the airport? Will you carry me?
Come on, Philip. You'll be all right. This message is exactly what you need now. It will refresh you. Do you remember that girl at the party?
Which girl? There were so many of them yesterday.
The one you were dancing lambadas with for about 2 hours. And then you promised her a nice holiday in Jamaica. Do you want to say you don't remember anything?
No, I'm afraid I don't. I mean, Matt, I didn't do anything wrong.
Oh no, you did great. You two make such a couple. Second to none. Yesterday, everyone looked at you while you were dancing in the middle of the room, jumping, shouting, splashing beer all over the place. I was amused too.
Splashing beer?
Splashing.
Oh no, what a shame!
Take it easy, Phil. Sometimes people go wild. I've done even worse. Anyway, it was fun. Relax.
Okay, but who's the girl? Short one? Dark curly hair? No?
No.
What does she look like?
Try to guess.
Maybe that blonde, tall and slim. Or another one. Of average height, fat. Green hair, a turned up nose, and a tattoo on her neck? That would be terrible. It's all because of my poor memory. I keep forgetting things.
Oh yes, I was right. He must quit smoking. It seems like he has forgotten everything. I won't describe the girl. Let it be a nice surprise for him. I suppose you don't remember her because she came too late. By that time, you were just about to have a swim in the Neva River, and it was she who stopped you from that. And there it all began. But why don't you ask me about a message?
Because I don't feel very optimistic about all that story. Okay, what's the message about?
She wants to go out with you tonight.
Go out? With me? Where does she want to go?
Yes, again.
Disco. I'm not in the mood. I haven't been to the disco since I was 16. After all, I hate discotheques. Maybe a casino or a restaurant. I'm afraid I can't afford it at the moment. Cinema? I'm quite sure I'll fall asleep as soon as I get there, so...
All wrong. She's not that type that goes to restaurants and discos. She's very, very special. She offers you to go with her to the zoo.
Zoo? I've seen the entrance. It looks terrible.
Maybe it looks terrible, but it's absolutely fantastic inside. And remember, don't judge the book by its cover. You'll love it. So, are you going?
Yeah, but how I recognize the girl? I don't even know her name.
Her name's Anne. And don't worry, you'll be able to identify each other. You spent hours together yesterday. And I hope her memory is not as poor as yours. So, you're meeting Anne at 4 o'clock by the entrance to the zoo. And don't forget, you're leaving tomorrow afternoon. Don't miss your plane.
Well, I suppose it's time to go now. Will we have a spare minute today?
Yes, sure. Why?
I'd like you to watch my new video report. Where is it? Oh. Here it is.
Thank you. Who was that?
Oh, cameraman.
Cameraman?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Say hello to Anne.
Okay. Bye.
I hope he won't get lost this time. So, let's check the video report.
About 8 or 9 years ago, you could hardly find a place in St. Petersburg with live music performed. Your only chance to enjoy live sound was to listen to the buskers playing their cheap instruments in the streets or underground subways. You could also go to pop or rock concerts, which sometimes took place at large stadiums or concert halls. There was no club scene at all, and occasional events such as Leningrad Rock Festival or John Lennon's birthday party were unofficially treated nearly as national holidays. They attracted huge crowds of people, varied from young rockers to middle-aged ex-hippies, who had no chance to see their favorite bands, apart from these special occasions. There were no clubs, no regular gigs, but the times have changed, and now the most confusing thing for the visitor in St. Petersburg is to choose between dozens and dozens of music venues that spread around the city in the last 2 years. So, tell me, Peter, what's St. Petersburg nightlife about?
Well, I have to say it's fun, first of all. Lots of different clubs and, you know, new clubs are being born, old ones have been closed. And well, the stage is quite diverse. I mean, we're having clubs like the Tunnel, say, the oldest techno venue in the country, and it's like 4 years old. And on the other hand, we would have dozens of new clubs open last week, like the Molar Court, say. Or, well, we have lots of underground rock clubs, which are really not commercial, and they're really good. I mean, perhaps St. Petersburg is one of the only last big cities in Europe where this kind of clubbing scene is left. Like, you know, cheap, dirty underground halls, like the Art Clinic, which is, well, closed already, but the Fish Fabric, things like that.
It's expensive. It's expensive to go in.
It really depends on the place. And, well, there are places where you can get in for 10 or 15,000, like, say.
How much is a beer?
And this kind of place is 5,000, 7,000.
Which, not bad.
It's cheap, isn't it? And on the other hand, you can find places where the cover charges are 150,000 rubles, which is quite a lot. And so it is really diverse. I mean.
So what about the last event? Has anything really great happened recently?
There was a big, actually a very big rave party, happened just a couple of days ago. It was a ruined castle in the Gulf of Finland. You know, huge, and they put all the sound systems there and the lights and the stroboscopes. And it was totally free, just sort of a big art happening. 3,000 people were there, dancing on the ruins of this 18th century castle, you know, quite impressive. And all the biggest DJs were playing. And it was kind of fun.
Is it mostly for teenagers, these sort of parties? What do you think?
No, that one was not really a teenage thing. It was kind of very sophisticated, very big scale party, you know.
Sophisticated? What do you mean by that?
A lot of really famous names were attracted, artists and performers and musicians of St. Petersburg. So the invitation ticket, which was given to, it was spread around friends and friends of friends. They listed the names, and among them were such famous art collectives as, say, Rishniki, the fishermen, or the rivermen, and some more celebs of St. Petersburg clubbing scene. So it was quite well done.
Would you recommend any places, any clubs, any sophisticated or maybe elegant places, nice places?
It's kind of a hard question. I mean, it all depends on your budget, first of all. So, if you prefer techno dance music, there are places like the Tunnel where cover charge is 30,000 and it's basically a teenage club, although it used to be an avant-garde one. And on the other hand, there are places like the Fish Fabric and Rock Club, which found some good art happenings happen there from time to time. And there are also clubs like the Candyman, say, which are really expensive and posh, and nice if you can afford it.
Thank you very much, Peter. Yeah, nice talking to you. We start our journey visiting Kosepop. After making a few steps down the stairs, we find ourselves in a dark and a bit scary place, with low ceiling and massive wooden tables all around. But loud music performed by a young but very energetic rockabilly band makes it clear that this is not the place for tracksuits and thick necks. The place is cheap and fun. Entrance fee is 10-15,000 rubles, and that makes it affordable both for Russian students and young clerks. If beer and dancing to live good old rock and roll is what you're looking for, you could hardly find a better place than Kosepop. This is the entrance to the popular music venue called Wild Side. It looks pretty shabby, but remember, don't judge the book by its cover. Let's try to get in. Three, 4 years ago, this club enjoyed the fame of one of the hippest places in St. Petersburg. Wild Side set itself up to become mecca of the best rock and pop bands of St. Petersburg, and it ended up more of an average standard music club, since many places of this type appeared in the city. But it still has great popularity among students, musicians and artistic types. The crowd is actually a bit of everything, but the place is quite safe and not too expensive. All trends of music are represented, from famous pop groups to young alternative bands playing their noisy hardcore stuff. If you're not a partygoer and aim to spend a quiet night in a peaceful and cozy bar, your best choice is the place called Old Cafe, with its nice music performed by a middle-aged piano player. We'll end our journey in this small and elegant cafe. And remember, whatever your taste or your budget, you can find a place in St. Petersburg you'll enjoy. Appearances. A bald bearded guy. Coffee makes you go to the bathroom, and I don't want to own a cafe, but my cousin does.
Check it out. Yes, indeed. Showing up me. I got the feeling to stretch on now. My children are crying.
A tall, skinny man.
I'm relying on the check for rent. If I gotta be broke, there ain't no joke. I'm moving to the country and buy some land, and I'll be all right.
With long fair hair. A rather fat guy, with a lovely smile, a plump man, with a red beard, a quite short girl, with dark curly hair. A slim girl of average height, with dark hair.
And now, something not to be missed. Grammar Guys!
You form the present perfect with have or has plus past participle. In spoken or informally written English, you use contractions.
I have finished my work. I've finished my work. She has just arrived. She's just arrived.
The idea of the present perfect is a connection of the action with now. The action in the past has a result now.
Phil has forgotten the name of that girl.
We use the present perfect to talk about experiences. We're not interested in when the action took place, but just in the experience. We often use ever and never to talk about experiences.
Have you ever tried jogging? I have never been to Africa.
You use the present perfect when you talk about a period of time that continues from past until now. You often use for and since when you talk about a period of time until now.
You've slept for 12 hours. I've been awake since 8 o'clock. Phil has never been to disco since he was 16.
You used the present perfect to announce the news.
I've bought a new car. John has moved to a new flat.
You used the present perfect with just, already, and yet. Just means a short time ago.
Would you like something to eat?
No, thanks. I've just had breakfast.
You use already to say that something happened sooner than expected. Yet means until now, and you use it only in questions and negatives.
Have you seen this show yet?
Yeah, I've seen it already.
This Philip, it's so much like him. Do you remember that girl offered him to go out with her yesterday night? They were supposed to go to the zoo. But do you know where they are now? No, neither do I. Phil never showed up yesterday after he had left. He didn't even call me. I've been awake all night long. I've been on my nerves. What had happened to my friend, I wondered. I made hundreds of phone calls, hospitals, police stations, and I drew terrible, terrible pictures in my mind. Phil broke his leg, or he was taken to the police. But nobody even heard about him. He just disappeared. Of course, I don't want him to break anything or to have any problems with the police. But where is he? But now, I'm not as nervous as I was yesterday. He finally called me this morning. Thank you very much indeed, my dear friend. So kind of you. He said it had never occurred to him that I could get worried. He forgot to call me. And of course, he's just fine. The zoo's fantastic. Animals are wild. The bear was great. White nights are terrific, and so on. But now, there's something he has to worry about. His plane. He forgot about it too. We've got only 1 hour. So, on the phone, he asked me to pack his bags, take him out, and wait for him outside. And he would take a taxi and do his best to come here as soon as possible, pick me up, and we would rush to the airport. Phil would try to catch his plane to Holland. Of course, I'm not a traitor. I can't leave my friend in such a situation. I've done exactly what he asked me about. But where is he? Where are you, Phil? They are. What a sweet pair.
Hi, Max.
Hello, Anne. How are you doing?
I'm just fine.
You are just fine. Philip, you are killing me. Where is your taxi?
Oh, Max, you live in a beautiful, beautiful city. We've decided to take a walk.
To take a walk? You are walking then? I've been sweating, packing your bags, taking them out, waiting for you down here. What do you think you're doing, huh? Come on, catch a taxi. Well, where about this? This one's free for hire. Go ahead, Philip, you'll be late for your plane.
Wait a bit, Max. I've got some good news and some bad news for you. Which one would you prefer to hear first?
Are you sure we've got time for this?
In any case, Max, I'd like you to answer my question. It's up to you to choose, good news or bad news?
Okay, bad.
Max, I know it might be painful, it's really dramatic, but you better find out about it now. Max, there are no more monkeys in the zoo. A zoo attendant told me, as the monkeys were not treated properly here, they have all been moved back to Africa. You'll never see a monkey in St. Petersburg anymore, can you imagine that?
Poor guy, what fantasies. Definitely he must go home. One more day in this city, and he will need a doctor. You know, I started getting sorry he didn't get to the hospital yesterday. That would have made him good. Take it easy, Phil. One day the monkeys will come back. Go ahead with good news, we'll catch a taxi and go to the airport.
The good news is, I lost my air ticket, Max. So, I'm not flying anywhere.
Oh no.
Don't judge the book by its cover. What was Philip complaining about? Why didn't Philip remember what the girl looked like? What have you learned about St. Petersburg's club scene? Where have the monkeys been moved to?